My name is Russ Vollmer, and I am the owner and operator of the Vollmer Farm in Bunn, North Carolina. Our farm is a five-generation-long family farm. Started in tobacco for several generations, including when I was a child here. That was the primary crop that we grew that paid our bills. And so the farm transitioned back in the 1990s and 2000s away from tobacco and into fruits and vegetables. And so we were conventional fruit and vegetable farm for several years. And then my dad started to see several issues with the crops that he was growing. The fact that he was having to apply more lime and more fertilizer to basically get the same results of the yield. And it came to his mind that there might be a better way that he wants to farm, and that was transitioning the farm from a conventional system to an organic system. With the use of cover crops, we are rotating vegetables, strawberries, and cover crops in that rotation, with at least 2 years rotation before the next strawberry crop goes in. The other, and I mentioned it, the use of cover crop, especially in an organic system, we try to pick the right crops that will actually put some nitrogen in the ground, as well as the ability to turn the crop into the ground and provide soil structure and health there. We also, on a yearly basis, apply about 1,000 pounds of organic matter, compost, to all of our fields. And then that's incorporated in when we prepare the land. So long term, what I see us heading towards is a 3-year crop rotation on strawberries, and probably even going to a 2-year rotation on vegetables. The soil fertility is a tricky thing. You know, it's a tricky thing. Yes, to say yes to that the simple answer to that is yes. Because of the sustainable practices that my father and I have continued, a lot less requirements for fertility, because it's already there. Probably 7 to 8 pounds of nitrogen. Typically we can count on to with our legumes that we're planting will go into the ground. The other part about that is just the ability for the plant to take up the nutrients that are there. Again, it kind of goes back to the soil health. And if your soil is healthy and a lot is going on in there, its ability to pick up those nutrients is a lot easier.